Dobri den, dohebu. When my colleagues at the U.S. Embassy started planning to celebrate the 75th anniversary of the liberation of Czechoslovakia, I was happy to learn I would finally have a chance to visit you in Hebr. I have heard impressive stories about your town. I heard about the difficult battle that took place around Hebr on April 25th of 1945, which ended in an American victory, but with tough losses. I heard about U.S. Ambassador Lawrence Steinhardt, who helped to unveil a memorial to fallen soldiers a year after that battle. And finally, I heard that ever since then, a U.S. diplomat would visit him each year to lay a wreath at the memorial, even under communist rule with the secret police watching. So I wish I could be with you in Hebr today. However, our shared struggle against the coronavirus requires me to reach out to you virtually. This year, we commemorate two important anniversaries. We pause today to pay special respect to the brave men and women, Americans, Czechs, and many others, who fought together 75 years ago to defeat fascism. We mark 75 years since the liberation of Hebr and the end of the brutal war that devastated Czechoslovakia and much of the rest of the world. We are also celebrating the 30th anniversary of our ability to freely share this commemoration with you. Ever since the Velvet Revolution of 1989, our embassy has proudly joined Czechs in commemorating the U.S. Army's liberation of southwestern Bohemia in 1945. The American people are grateful for your ongoing commemoration of the U.S. role in liberating this country. You honor our friendship with your tributes to the generation who sacrificed for freedom. These soldiers laid the foundation for the peace, the security, and prosperity we enjoy today. Indeed, America was here to help 75 years ago, America is here today, and America will be here tomorrow. We remember the anniversary of the battle that was fought here. I'm reminded of the stirring words of U.S. President Abraham Lincoln 157 years ago as he paid solemn tribute to the fallen during the U.S. Civil War at Gettysburg, Pennsylvania battlefield. Listen to Lincoln. Quote, "In a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men in living and dead who struggled here have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living rather, to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced." So as we reflect on the past, let us also look forward. As Lincoln suggested, we face different challenges now, but we must never lose sight of the principles for which the generation of 45 fought: freedom, security, democracy, human rights, and the rule of law. Let us remember that they gave their todays for our tomorrows. Our duty is to respect their sacrifice and defend these principles. Czechs and Americans, friends then and now as NATO allies, we stand united and remain eternally committed to this pledge. Never forget, never again. Česť jí, pamatuj.